After the pronator teres muscles, now I'm going to talk about the medial most muscles with respect to pronator teres at the forearm region. The anterior compartment of the forearm region is your flexor carpi radialis. This one is your flexor carpi radialis muscle. Here you can see, this is the flexor carpi radialis. This muscle is your flexor carpi radialis. This one you can see here. So this flexor carpi radialis, this is the muscle of the anterior compartment of the forearm, which is placed medially, just medial to the pronator teres, just medial to the pronator teres. So this muscle is also originates from the medial epicondyle of the humerus, which is the common flexor origin, okay, and inserted into the base of the second and third metacarpal bone, base of the second and third metacarpal bone. So obviously this muscle, the flexor carpi radialis, is crossing your elbow joint, is crossing your elbow joint anteriorly, okay. It is also crossing your wrist joint anteriorly, all right, and it is also crossing the metacarpophalangeus joint. Okay, not metacarpophalangeus joint, just is crossing your elbow anteriorly and wrist joint anteriorly. Okay, so obviously any muscle which is crossing any joint anteriorly causing the flexion of that joint. So obviously your flexor carpi radialis muscle causing weak flexion at elbow region and strong flexion at the wrist region. Actually carpi, the carpi means carpi, the word suggests wrist, okay, carpi the word suggests wrist. So flexor of the wrist along the radial side or along the radius side, okay. So this is your radius, this is your ulna, that's why this muscle is called your flexor carpi radialis, okay. So this flexor carpi radialis originates from the medial epicondyle. Here you can see the medial epicondyle of the humerus from anterior surface, which is the common flexor origin, and then it going anterior to the wrist joint, and finally it's attached or inserted into the base of second and third metacarpal bone, all right. Now the tendon of flexor carpi radialis is a good guide to the radial artery, which lie just lateral to it at the wrist, okay. So radial artery and the tendon of flexor carpi radialis, actually the radial artery also running along with the same flexor carpi radialis at the wrist region. At the wrist region your radial artery is lateral to your flexor carpi radialis, okay. So you can see here this thing you can see here, the tendon of flexor carpi radialis is a good guide for radial artery, which lie just lateral to it at wrist. At wrist region your radial artery lying laterally and flexor carpi radialis tendon lying medially, okay. So now let's talk about the nerve supply of this muscle, flexor carpi radialis. First of all, you can see also this in Pronator's Atlas. This is your flexor carpi radialis muscle, this one. This is your medial epicondyle of the humerus, okay, medial epicondyle of the humerus, anteriorly the common flexor tendon. This is the common flexor tendon. All the flexors are originates from the medial epicondyle of the humerus in this region, and you can see here, this is the flexor carpi radialis muscle. This flexor carpi radialis muscle running along with running on the radius bone along with the radial artery, okay, and then this flexor carpi radialis tendon attached or inserted into the second and third metacarpal, base of the second and third metacarpal. You can see here this one and this one, the base of second and third metacarpal bone, okay, and originates from your medial epicondyle originates from your medial epicondyle. So this is the origin and insertion of the flexor carpi radialis muscle. Now it's nerve supply. Already I told that all the muscles of your anterior region of the forearm is generally supplied by your median nerve, except flexor carpi ulnaris, okay, and the another one is your the deep muscle flexor digitorum profundus muscle, deep muscle, its medial head. The flexor digitorum profundus, its medial head or medial half, okay, medial half, and not actually medial head, actually the medial half, and the flexor carpi ulnaris, these two muscles are supplied by your ulnar nerve. Except these two muscles, all the muscles are supplied by your median nerve. So flexor carpi radialis is obviously supplied by your median nerve. This is supplied by your median nerve. Okay, that's all about the nerve supply. And now let's talk about its function. What's the function of your flexor carpi radialis muscle? So already I told that the flexor carpi radialis, it is crossing your elbow and it's crossing your wrist joint anteriorly. Okay, so and its name suggests that flexor means flexor carpi radialis. Okay, its name suggests that carpi mean your wrist. Actually, this muscle, when it contracts, causing the flexion of the wrist, okay, or flexion of the carpi, and this muscle is located towards the radial side or towards the radial bone. That's why this is called your flexor carpi radialis muscle. Okay, and whenever I am talking about the flexion of the wrist, let's talk about this through a diagram. Okay, so here in this diagram, yes, in this diagram you can see various movements of your hand and wrist joint, various movement of the wrist joint. You can see this is the flexion movement. This is the flexion movement. Okay, so now I am only talking about the flexion movement and also abduction movement or okay, so this is the flexion movement, and you can see this is a radial deviation. This point is important movement. Radial deviation, that means the this is the abduction or a lateral deviation or radial deviation, also called the lateral abduction of the wrist. Okay, actually this is deviated towards the radial bone. Okay, this is, that's why this is also called your radial deviation, and this is your the deviation towards the ulna. That's why this is also called your ulna deviation. The radial deviation is caused by or the abduction of the wrist is caused by your flexor carpi radialis, obviously, and not only the flexor carpi radialis, also the extensor carpi radialis. This extensor carpi radialis is not the muscle of the anterior compartment of the forearm. So I already told that radial deviation is caused by two muscles, the flexor carpi radialis and the extensor carpi radialis. Extensor carpi radialis is not the muscle of the anterior compartment of the forearm. Extensor carpi radialis is the muscle of the posterior compartment of the forearm or extensor compartments. Okay, whatever, they are both are acting synergistically and causing your radial deviation of the wrist, okay, or abduction, ABD, abduction of the wrist. And here you can see the ulnar deviation. During this ulnar deviations, also two muscles are acting here, the extensor carpi ulnaris and the flexor carpi ulnaris. These two muscles, the extensor carpi ulnaris and flexor carpi ulnaris, also causing the ulnar deviation. Synergistically, these two are acting on the wrist joint and causing the deviation of the wrist joint towards the ulnar bone, or this is also called ADD adduction. Okay, similarly, extensor carpi ulnaris is not the muscle of your anterior compartment of the forearm, Okay, so this is also the muscle of the extensor compartment, posterior compartment of the forearm. But you can see here the two muscles. You can see here the two muscles, the flexor carpi radialis here, and also the flexor carpi radialis, and flexor carpi ulnaris. Okay, the flexor carpi radialis causing the abduction or the lateral deviation or the radial deviation of the wrist, and the flexor carpi ulnaris causing the opposite action. So these two muscles are the antagonist, flexor carpi radialis and flexor carpi ulnaris. Okay, these two muscles are antagonist to each other, acting on the wrist joint, causing two opposite action. One is your radial deviation, another one is your ulnar deviation. R for radial, and towards the radial side is causing your radial deviation. Ulnar for you causing the ulnar deviations. All right. So you can see the flexor carpi radialis along with the flexor carpi ulnaris, they both acting antagonistically and causing the antagonist action. Okay. This is one antagonist action of these two muscles. And also you can see another muscle's action. This is your flexor carpi radialis and flexor carpi ulnaris. Both are flex the wrist simultaneously. One thing you can see, this is the flexion. This flexion is caused by your flexor carpi radialis and flexor carpi ulnaris. Okay. This time both are acting synergistically. These two muscles, flexor carpi radialis and flexor carpi ulnaris, acting synergistically and causing the flexion of the wrist joint. Okay, and here you can see flexor carpi radialis, flexor carpi ulnaris, they are acting antagonistically. Okay, and causing the abduction and adduction respectively at the wrist joint. So the point which I want to highlight here is the flexor carpi radialis causing the flexion of the wrist joint along with flexor carpi ulnaris. Both are flexing the carpi or the wrist, okay, from radial side and ulnar side respectively. And also your flexor carpi radialis causing the radial deviation, okay, which is the antagonistic movement of the flexor carpi ulnaris muscle. Okay, and one thing which also I told, that flexor carpi radialis along with extensor carpi radialis, they are causing the radial deviation. This extensor carpi radialis is not the muscle of anterior compartment, that's why we are not discussing this thing now. And similarly, flexor carpi ulnaris acting with flexor carpi extensor carpi ulnaris, causing the adduction or the ulnar deviation. Similar things, these two muscles are antagonist to each other, and here these two muscles are synergist with each other. Okay, so in the next video I'll talk about the plantaris and other muscles.